and welcome to Hot Topics in Hypnotherapy. My name is Lisa Machenberg, and I'll be your host today on the show that explores new ideas, interesting people, and important developments in the field of hypnotherapy. Today, we're going to talk about hypnosis and sports performance. Our guest today is Ron Thomas. He is an author, actor, speaker, life coach, and graduate of the Hypnosis Motivation Institute. Please help me welcome Sensei Ron Thomas. Thank you. Now, Ron, you know where I remember you from?
Let me guess.
The Karate Kid, the original Karate Kid.
Cobra Kai never die.
That's right. And you played Bobby Brown, and you were the boy who beat up the Karate Kid and actually broke his leg.
Correct.
Yeah. How did you go from being an actor? You're still an actor. What kind of things are you working on now? Yeah.
Currently, well, we just did a spoof on The Karate Kid, actually. I did one with Marty Cove on Tosh.0. Oh,
I can't wait to see
it. It's very funny. Yeah. It's very funny, yeah.
But you're also a speaker and a life coach and a hypnotherapist. How are you combining hypnotherapy with the martial arts?
Well, I'm kind of moving out of the field of one-on-one hypnotherapy and working on some seminars, coincidentally, with the martial arts, or not so coincidentally, with the martial arts. I have a coaching program called A Black Belt in Excellence, and I'm writing another book. I'm not going to give you the title right now, but it's quite funny.
I bet. Well, I'm looking at this current book called Positive Thinking Is for Sissies. Well, I always thought that positive thinking was for manifestors. How come positive thinking is for sissies?
For manifestors.
That's what I thought.
So you can be a positive thinker and still be broke.
This is true.
You can be a positive thinker and still be frustrated at life. You can be a positive thinker and still be not winning your game in sports. Mm-hmm. So it has to go deeper than positive thinking. I find a lot of that people that are using positive thinking as a means to an end aren't quite getting to the end.
That's right.
So there has to be more. So positive thinking is for sissies because positive thinking makes you feel good in the moment. You know, it's like every cloud has a silver lining. When one door closes, another one opens, and that makes you feel good, right?
Sure.
But it's temporary. Mm-hmm. And the real theme behind the book, and by the way, it's a book series, so this is book one, and if you read the subtitle, it's Master Your Damn Emotions.
I like it.
So, which really means master your negative emotions, which is for warriors. It's not for sissies. It takes a person who's willing to take a good long look in the mirror at themselves, their behaviors, their emotions, and really get a grip on those emotions and master them rather than have those negative emotions mastering you.
So how do you use hypnosis to master your negative emotions or master your damn emotions?
Well, a good hypnotherapist could use, let's take anxiety as an example. Mm-hmm. As long as the hypnotherapist understands anxiety and what it really is, they can translate that to their client. And if they understand that anxiety is an emotion of the future, that you can't really be anxious about last week because it's already done, but you can certainly be worryful or anxious about next week. And if you can teach your client to be present and in the moment and understand what anxiety really is, it's an emotion about fear of change.
Yes.
And so if this happens, that happens next week, then everything will change, my world will change, it'll come to an end. So once you understand that on a cognitive level, a great hypnotherapist can reduce that anticipatory anxiety.
Sure. And of course, anxiety is an emotion about the future. All anxiety is anticipatory anxiety.
Pretty much.
And bring that now into sports performance. Certainly, I worry about my matches the night before.
You do?
Shocking.
I know a good hypnotherapist.
I bet. So, he even wrote a book.
He did. So yeah, it goes even deeper than that or more subtle than that. Even in the match, you could be worried about the next point, which is the future.
Yes.
And what you'll come to understand as an athlete is that the mind jumps into the past or the future all the time, which means you're very rarely present. And if you can learn how to be present, which is one of the qualities of the zone, and when you're working with athletes, what you really want to teach them is how to be in the zone and how to create the zone on purpose rather than having the zone just sort of happen.
See, I find that the zone happens and it's really, really random.
Right.
So how can I use hypnotherapy to actually create the zone? Talk me through it.
Yeah. And a lot of athletes feel that way. Like they pray for the zone to happen, right? So I believe you can create it on purpose through going to your mental gym daily and training mentally as much or more than you do physically, because at a certain level in athletics, especially I work with professional athletes, and when you hit a certain level, it goes way beyond physical now.
Yes.
And most professional athletes will tell you it's 90% mental and only 10% physical.
Sure.
And so you've got to go to your mental gym daily, and you've got to learn how to create the zone. And one of the things you're creating to be in the zone, you have to be relaxed. You have to be mentally calm, physically relaxed. Mm-hmm. That's one of the qualities. And another quality is you have to be present. You can't be jumping into the past or the future all the time.
Uh-huh.
Athletes have this amazing quality about them. They want to control everything.
Yeah.
They want to force things to happen, make things happen, make the next point happen.
Uh-huh.
But all of that creates tension, which means you're not relaxed. It also means you're focused into the future, about making that future happen,
yes.
No matter how far into the future that is, minute, you know, in terms of seconds or minutes.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and all of that takes you out of the zone.
Yes.
If you can get in touch with your senses, which are always present, in other words, if I were to walk over and whack you one upside the head right now, it would bring you into the present moment because you'd be in touch with your physical senses. Mm-hmm.
So, as opposed to bringing you with me to whack me right before a match, which I suppose is an option, but is it the best option? Because you're off doing seminars, how can I bring my mental gym with me
and
be able to get in touch with my senses and be present in that moment?
Right.
Every moment, or when I need to be.
Right. So you like tennis. You play tennis.
Uh-huh.
So one of the things that I teach athletes to do, and if you're a tennis player, is you can just get in touch with the feeling of the racket in your hand.
Yes.
Just take a moment and just get in touch with the grip, the leather, mm-hmm. the temperature outside, the court beneath your shoes. If you can connect, you know, just feel the different court, the clay court versus the dirt court, the grass court. All of those has different, give you different information through
yes.
your senses, even the smell in the air. And if you're just in tune with that, your mind, you're all of a sudden, you've detached from your mind. And you're attached to your senses, which are giving you information about the present moment. It's one of the quickest ways to just get present and then learn how to train yourself or tease yourself into what we would call a state of being in the zone.
I like it because I'm either at the last point
right.
or the next point.
Right.
But I need to be in the present by getting in touch with all five senses.
Right. And if you're at the last point, that's where frustration or anger comes in, because
yes.
that's an emotion of the past. Something has to occur before you can be frustrated or angry.
Uh-huh.
And then there's something that might occur in the future which causes you anxiety. And so you can bounce back and forth through all of those emotions. But when you'll notice at those times when the zone did happen,
yes.
even if it was random, none of that stuff was going on.
That's right.
You were just enjoying the game.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So that helps me to master my damn emotions.
Correct.
What else? What else can I do to get that mastery?
Well, that's huge. Learning how to master as human beings, we all want to control everything. We've been taught to control. The only thing you can control is yourself.
Yes.
Control your mind, control your thoughts, control your game, control your talent, control your business, control your finances, control, control, control. Have you noticed that pushing and pulling at life doesn't really work? And you're trying to control everything and everyone all the time, that at some point you find yourself exhausted?
Yes.
And you just want to... So it's not about being in control, it's about being in command. Being in control is reactive, being in command is being in response mode, which is one step closer to self-mastery, which is what this book is all about.
I love it.
Thank you.
Well, you know, I like positive thinking, but I like mastery or commanding even better.
Yeah.
Now, you're a graduate from the Hypnosis Motivation Institute.
Correct.
And you're integrating some of the things you learned also into your speaking career.
Correct.
Tell me how you're using that to bring the gifts of hypnotherapy to a wider audience.
Well, there's lots to my background. If you research me or go to my website, you'll find lots of things uh-huh. that add up to my background. But hypnosis and NLP, which mm-hmm. I also learned at HMI, uh-huh. are some of the things that I incorporate in my speaking. And some of the very things we're talking about right now are huge for people. Just the idea of control versus command.
Yes.
Being present. I give people a great exercise. At lunch, I have people go with a partner and blindfold themselves. and I have the partner feed them, and they have to have at least three different varieties of food on their plate.
Uh-huh.
And so they're completely blindfolded, and they have to sort of guess what they're eating. But the interesting thing is, when you're present to the meal, guess what? You actually taste it.
Yes.
And so you're more in tune with your senses, which are giving you much more information about what's really happening. And while you're eating the food, you're very present to the meal, and they taste things they've never tasted before. They feel in their mouth the texture of the food,
yes,
which otherwise, not doing this exercise, they would have skipped right over because their mind would have been, guess where?
Either the last meal or the next meal,
right.
That's right.
Or what movie they're gonna see after the meal, or, you know, so I find that we're crazy as human beings. You know, I give the example of Friday night comes and we've had a long week, and what do you wanna eat? I don't know, what do you wanna eat? I don't know, what do you feel like eating? Well, I feel like eating a hamburger, shake and fries. No, it's too greasy. Let's get a pizza. Well, that's greasy too. Well, how about fish? And we go through this whole mental energy and spend all this energy on having the right and perfect meal. But when we get to the restaurant and we finally order it, we're not even tasting it. We taste the first bite. Now our mind is on to what the boss said this morning or what movie we're going to see next after the, you know, we're crazy.
I can certainly see how that feeds right into being able to be present in any field of endeavor.
Yeah,
well,
correct.
We can reach you through the HMIgrads.com for anyone who would like to get more information for Sensei Ron Thomas. We need to take a short break. But please stay tuned, because when we come back, we'll continue our discussion about hypnotherapy and sports performance. We'll be right back. Thank you so much. This is great. Positive.